So with respect to mains answer writing, you should know that every question has some different parts, right? So these are some of the general tips which you should keep in mind whenever you are writing some answers with respect to general studies mains, right? So every answer has some different parts. Like if there is a question for 10 marks or for 12.5 marks or 15 marks, then the question will be divided into different sub parts, right? 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, right? So these sub parts have to be answered by you, right? So you have to keep in mind that if there is a 10 marker question, then it will be equally divided into 2 or 3 parts, sub parts, right? So that might vary, right? Like in the first part you might be writing a definition, so that would be just a small part of your answer, a small sub part of your answer, right? So with respect to 10 marks, then first part you have to answer, then second part that there might be some concerns asked, then in the third part you might be asked about to write some solutions, right? So this is the general pattern of questions which are asked in UPSC, right? So these are some of the sub parts of the questions which have to be clearly identified by you and properly answered. So weightage might vary with respect to 10 marker, with respect to 12.5 marker, with respect to 15 marker, the weightage might vary, but the main thing is identify these sub parts. For example, consider this first question. The idea of one nation, one language has gained currency in the recent part, right? So this first statement is itself saying something, right? Just keep in mind that this statement is saying something, right, which we have to take note whenever we are writing the answer. Now further, discuss its feasibility in a diverse country like India, right? Discuss its feasibility in a diverse country like India. So this question will have 2 or 3 subparts, right? 2 or 3 subparts which we have to answer. First of all, the idea of one nation, one language. First of all, we will have to explain what is meant by this one nation, one language, right? First of all, so in 1 or 2 lines you can explain this concept of one nation, one language, and how it is gaining the currency, that means it is gaining the importance, it is a hot topic, it is being debated right now in a few months or in a few years, right? So why it has gained the currency? So first part is this. Then the second is discuss will mean that you have to tell something positive or something negative, right? It with respect to this question, it might be that why it should be done or why it is gaining the currency and how it could be done. So any of these will come under the positive point, right? Then there are negative point, that is the concern, right? So there are certain concerns why it cannot be done, or what are the negative externalities, or what are the hurdles in this one nation, one language concept, right? So discuss would mean this. Then after that you have to come with a solution, right? You have to come with a solution. So these are the different sub parts of that question. First is the concept. What is that concept of one nation, one language? Then what are the positive externalities or the feasibility? What are the negative or the concerns? Then solution. Now since it is a 10 marker question, so the concept may be explained in 1 or 2 lines, or you can consider that this question will have 2 marks for this and rest 4 marks for this, or you can say 3.5 or 3.5 for this and rest of the marks for solutions, right? So this will be the broad framework of your answers, right? So all the questions which we will be discussing will be divided into sub parts, right? Because the examiner will be having the model answers and he will be checking the answers as per the subparts, and all the subparts should be adequately answered.